My name is Amir. I work in Insightec, and I'll talk about the project I did within my company. The project is about finding anatomical markers in the brain using MRI volumes. This process is guided by MR, which monitors the temperature in the region of the treatment and makes sure we don't harm adjacent regions. The main clinical applications we have currently are the exablate neuro, which treats within the brain, the prostate system, which ablates the cancer tumor of the prostate, and the bone system, which is used for pain palliation by ablating nerves surrounding the bone in bone cancer metastasis. The project is related to essential tremor. Essential tremor is the most common movement disorder. It causes a patient not to be able to grab a glass of water without shaking and spill it all around. The impact of the treatment is very high. Let's look at an example. This is an example of a handwriting of a patient in the morning before the treatment. Just after 2 hours after the treatment, his handwriting looks like this. So the impact is very significant, and it's a life changer. Looking at it as a ML project, what we want to do is what we are doing in this treatment is we are ablating a known clinical point in the brain, which is known to be responsible to this movement disorder. However, this point can't be seen in the MR volumes, but there are known landmarks that can be seen in the MR volumes, which are called anterior and posterior commissures, the AC and PC we'll call them, and they may be found in the MR volumes. We can define our point by its relation to these landmarks. Currently, finding the AC and PC landmarks is done manually. The point is that this is time consuming. Now, this is very important because the user in the treatment is within the MR device. This is not comfortable. And if we can make the treatment shorter, it will improve significantly the patient experience. Sometimes it will be the difference between success or failure of the treatment. Finding them manually also might suffer from operator's error. So let's look at it as an ML project. We want to find the landmarks automatically with high success rates. The method is to create a CNN model to predict these landmarks by using the data from previous treatments. The process is supervised by the operator. So in very difficult, rare cases, if we don't find correctly the AC and PC automatically, it's acceptable as the user will fix this. There is an additional outcome of finding these landmarks. They may be used as initial guess for multimodal registration. For example, with the CT volume, this is also part of the flow of the treatment. So let's look how these landmarks looks like. So I hope you can see it clear in the image. We see here a sagittal slice in the middle of the brain. The red point is the AC, and the yellow one is the PC. Let's zoom in. I hope you can see the landmarks are located on kind of a valley on this tissue. But one of the problems is that different treatments have different MR devices and use different modalities of MR scans. For example, this is a very different type of image, and we should find that the CNN models should handle all types of images we have in the treatments. Another example shows a very noisy case. In such case, it will be acceptable not to find the AC and PC automatically. And in this example, we can see the geometry differences between different images, and we can also see that there is a difference in the way the operator assigned these landmarks. we can see that on the left image, he assigned them on the edge of the segment, while in the right one, he assigned, assigned them farther away. There was no accurate specification what is a good result. The experts said we should find the landmarks within the valley. I assigned it here in blue circles. So let's talk a bit about the data we have. We have saved data from several hundreds of previous treatments. For each treatment, we have the MR volumes. I use the axial slices, axial volume. Axial slices looks like this, and the sagittal slices, which go like this. For each treatment, we also have the landmarks that the user marked, so we have the labels, actually. As I showed, there is a large difference between the different treatment, both in the images, types, and quality, and also in the way the markers were assigned. There was also some work on collecting the data, as it was not saved, organized for ML project. So how did I access this problem? I try to find the landmarks as key points by using heat map regression. In this method, we create labels in this way. If we want to find a point, we create label image with a shape around this point. For example, in this image, if we want to find this man's elbow, we create a label with a circle around the elbow location. Then I used UNET. UNET is a very known and strong tool for segmentation. But instead of training it for segmentation, I trained it to find the heat map shapes of the label images. To find the landmarks, we get the label image, and we find the center of mass of it. And finally, we should go and find a solution for 3D volumes, because we don't know the location in all the three volumes. So how does the training look like? This example was done on the 2D case. I took the slices. I know the landmark are on. So in the left image, you can see the slice. And on it, I put the label in its center. After several epochs, there are many regions that are firing to be suspected to be this heat map. But as we continue to train, the non-relevant regions decays until after 750 epochs, we get quite similar results to the label image. But we have to give a solution for the 3D case. We don't know the location in all the directions. So I use 2.5 frame framework. In this framework, I train 2D slices, but as I need also the third dimension, I used the surrounding slices as additional channels. This means for every slice, I have the slice itself, but I used the slices above and below and as additional channels of this slice, of these 2D slices. Then I did several 2D data augmentations, and I trained all the slices on the volume. Now, you can understand that most slices on the volume, the label image is empty. It's not close to the landmark. So I used as loss function, generalized dice loss. This loss function takes care for two things. First, it gives high weights for small labels. My label is very small related to the whole volume. And second, it deals with slices that don't have a label at all. And finding the landmarks is by finding a 3D center of mass of the volume I found from all the slices predictor. This is here I show how the label looks like. On the slice on which the landmarks exist, there is a large label, and as we get far from it, the label becomes smaller until it disappears. I trained about 260 volumes for previous treatments. For each one, I had several slices. I trained it for 800 epochs. I trained four models for AC and PC, sagittal and axial. And the loss function was reduced to a quite stable level of 0.3 to 0.4. So let's look at the results. The results actually were quite good. For the sagittal volume, I got an average error of less than 1 millimeter. The error is defined by the difference between the user marking and what the CNN found. The standard deviation was about 0.5 millimeter, and more than 95% were below 2 millimeters. For the axial volume, we get a bit weaker results, but still quite good. The results were similar for the train and validation sets, which means we didn't overfit, and it may be improved by combining the results in these two volumes. Now, the important point, or the interesting point, is when I looked at the problematic cases where I had large difference between the user marking and my result, I saw that many times the results of the CNN was actually better than the result, than what the user assigned. This means that actually the results we got are much better than what is shown here, at least for the high percentage. So let's look at some example. This is the typical case. In the left image, you can see part of the sagittal image and slice, and in the right one, the axial. Here, in yellow cross, is the result of the predictor. In red cross is what the user assigned. We can see that they are very close to each other. This is the typical case. It is what happened most of the times. Here we can see an example where the behavior of the image is a bit different. We don't have the circular valley we are used to, so the results were a bit different between the predictor and the user. And this is the case where the results of the CNN were much better. We know that the landmark, both of them, should sit on the symmetry line of the tissues that are shown here. I hope you can see that the yellow cross, the results of the predictor, is sitting on the center line, but the red one is farther away to the side. So here, the result of the predictor was much better than what the user assigned. This is an example where the predictor didn't find the AC and the PC, and in such cases, it's acceptable. As I said, it's supervised by the operator, so we can fix these cases, or maybe take again the MR volume. Similar example for the posterior commissure, very close results. We can see that it handles different types and modalities of images. And one interesting case, we have here, instead of one valley, I got two valleys. So what happened is that the predictor assigned the upper one, and the user assigned the lower one. I asked the experts, the clinical experts in the company, and most of them said that the yellow is the correct one. I did also two extensions to this project. First was to apply the same mechanism to the CT volume. The motivation is if I have these landmarks, both for the CT and for the MR, it may be used for a multimodal registration. However, the CT volume quality is lower in the brain, as it was aimed to find the bone of the skull. So I had to do some pre-processing as a gray level clipping, 3D blurring, and finally a 3D resampling to the sagittal orientation, and the results were quite good as a proof of concept. The average error was below 1.5 millimeters. The other extension I did is to find a midline point. Midline point is a point on the plane, on the symmetry, on the center plane of the brain between its two side hemispheres. This point is needed for full 3D localization. is if we have two landmarks, and we might rotate around the round the line between them. So finding an additional point we can find full 3D localization. What I did is I took the coronal slice between the AC and PC, and I assigned manually. I assigned a stable element, a symmetry element between the brain verticals and the train the net. The results here were very good. The average was about 0.2 millimeters, as the feature was very strong. So to summarize the project, I implemented a 2.5D unit for heat map regression to find the landmarks. The results were quite good and definitely acceptable for what the company needs. I extended it to a city volume and for a finding midline point. And integration of this solution may reduce the treatment time, which will ease the patient experience, as I said, and will also save money, as MRI money is very expensive. Making the treatment shorter will save a lot of money. So that's it, and thank you all for your attention. Have a nice evening. Thank you.